whatever this class is, the Circle of Women, I'm going to direct most of it to Barb because she's the only one here. But she's always wanted to know why we're always laughing so much down here anyhow, so now she'll find out. And this class is listed as relax, everything's going to be okay, which is a good motto for right about now. And I think the best thing to do is start off with some laughter. And I was going to, for those who have forgotten, or for those of you who are just tuning in for the first time, this is how you do it. When you're very oh-hum and not happy about anything and you're down, the first thing you do is say, ah, with great disgust. And then you say, ah, ah. And then you try a third one, ah, ah, ah. And a fourth one, ah, 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 ah. And the fifth one, and you have to keep laughing till everybody in the room is laughing. And already you feel more relaxed and good. So throughout the rest of this session, whenever we need a break, we'll just go, ha! And then everybody will start laughing. So this is about relaxing. And one of the first things we'd like to do to start is to do a head massage. And so remember, we sit in a circle and we'll do the head massage, and you start and just start scratching the top of your head. And oh, that feels so good. And make some sounds and ooh, get right into it. And especially at the back of your neck, that's where all the tension sits. So give that a good scratch up and down. And ooh, you know how if you tickle your dog's neck, he'll kind of moan too. So get some moaning in there. Oh, oh. Oh, 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 and you'll feel better already. Just stop for a minute. Oh, how's that feel? Shake off a little bit. Oh. Now, we're going to massage your face, and because of, you know, the not touching your face rule, I brought a little bit of peroxide. That's what I like for you. A little spritz on your hand. Spritz your hands. And it's very, I've got a very quiet spritzer here. So, oops. Sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Ah, there we go. And then you can massage your face. And one of the places where a lot of tension is right here over your eyebrows. So just bring your middle finger. Give your face the middle finger. Up over your eyebrows, just stretch. Oh, that feels so good. And you can feel it. Oh, you want to be in the feeling. Feel it. Oh, oh, that feels good. That feels good. And then do your temples, you know. A lot of things to worry about these days, but for the moment, I'm not going to. And then you massage your forehead. There's another really sweet spot right on the corner of your nose, up over your cheekbones. Oh, just doesn't that feel good? Oh, and you don't have to go anywhere. You can do this in your bed first thing in the morning before you can get out of bed. Do your chin. Oh, just, oh, doesn't that feel good? Oh, now when we're usually when we're doing this, everybody goes around the circle and says something really fine and wonderful that happened for them today. And you think the best thing, well, we usually do it since we meet once a week, we usually do the best thing that happened to you during the week. So I'll try the best thing that happened for me this morning. Oh, I was trying to get a hold of Canada Post to see why a package hadn't been delivered. Finally, I talked to a human being. Things to be grateful for. So someone on the end of a government phone with a person. Now, this doing your ears is really, ooh, it's a wonderful thing to just feel back behind your ears. Lots of tension there. Oh. And remember, if you massage your ear, you can actually relax every part of your body. There's this theory out anyhow that your ear connects to every part. Oh, wiggle it a bit, pull on it, tug. Oh, it's so important to make the sounds too, because we don't want to suffer in silence. Just make some nice. I haven't got Barb laughing yet. She's not even doing her face. She could be standing there videotaping. She's not massaging. Oh, that feels good, hey? I feel my ears are warming up now. They say someone must be talking about me. If your ears are burning, move. Now, one of the things that we get tense in is our jaw, because you know when you're stressed out, you tend to clench your teeth like this. And so there's this little trick you can use. You put your thumbs under your chin, and open against your thumbs. And you hold it for about 10-15 seconds. Because with jaw clenching, you can put your fingers right here, clench your jaw, and you'll feel that muscle tighten up. Ooh, ooh. And that one is tight all the time because you don't want to walk around with your mouth hanging open. So it keeps a certain tension on it. But the way to relax this is do the opposite movement, is you open against some resistance. And then that muscle has to let go. And if you happen to be the kind of person that grinds your teeth at night, dentist has probably told you, he's probably sold you a $500 device for your, to keep you from clenching your teeth. Just do this for 20 seconds before you go to sleep at night. That muscle will let go. And really, oh, doesn't that feel better? Oh, I think it's time for another laugh. If you ever get stuck, look on YouTube for some baby laughing, make you laugh all the time. If you try that though, doing the ha, counting one, two, three, four, until you're starting to laugh. It's a good trick. I learned it from laughing yoga. And just your whole body feels better if you can laugh. And it just becomes very natural. The first few don't feel natural because you just, But when you get into it, and just keep laughing. Okay, shake your mouth a little bit more. And it's good to make another thing that helps you relax too, when just to finish your face massages. Just give somebody the raspberry. That feels good. Now, here's another trick I can show you. Is about, you know, sometimes you wake up and, sometimes just from the tension, you've got your shoulders way up around your ears and your neck doesn't turn, it gets stiff, you have a crink in your neck. Well, so here's what you can do, another trick. And you just first turn your head to see how far you can see. I can just see the edge of the fireplace turning that way. And then over here, I can just see the name on the fireplace. So that's how far my head will turn. Now we're gonna do this. Roll your shoulders a couple of times. Breathe out. And then press your shoulders back and down. And turn your tongue up to the roof of your mouth. And stretch your neck tall. You want your neck long. Pull your chin in so your head is sitting over top of your shoulders. Then you're in position. Now just turn your eyes. Right. And without moving your head, over each shoulder. And there's a reflex. When you turn your eyes, your head prepares to follow. So you're kind of doing an isometric exercise here. You're not moving. And then let everything go. And then turn your head and just check and see how much further you can go. I've probably gained about 4 inches on the screen in the fireplace there. And then this way, I can see the whole name on the fireplace. But this is a really good thing. Sometimes you get pain in your arm if you've got a, you know, like a pinched nerve in your neck or you've been sleeping on it wrong. And it's a good thing to do. And you can do it like anywhere. If it's really sore, lie down on the floor with your knees bent and do it from lying down, and then you push that back in. So we'll go through it again. Just roll your shoulders and do some breathing. And shoulders back and down, chin in. Curl your tongue back and to the roof of your mouth, and then roll your eyes. Check out and see if even better. Your head will turn much easier, and if you've had any pain in your neck, like you'll feel that disappear too. Now, one of the things that's good to do, I should have done this before I did the neck, but you want to massage your shoulders. And you can hold your elbow up so that it's not working too hard. And just, and you'll find a spot in your shoulders, like there's usually a knot, and you just press that. And you can roll your shoulder underneath as you're doing it. Oh, doesn't that feel good? And you feel let go. And work right into that muscle, because that's a big tension muscle too. And I find it's really important to make the sounds that releases a lot of tension, because usually when we're scared we go very silent and quiet, and we don't want to make a noise, and especially women, you know, are trained not to be too noisy or too loud. Definitely don't laugh too much. And it helps if you're moving the muscles under your hands when you're doing the massage too. And then you can just kind of do both sides of your neck. Stretch your neck. Fabulous ladies that always sit in this circle, I imagine you're here. I'm going to send you an email so you'll know to watch this too. But Barb's taking it all in. She's going to be a changed person. We should have done a before and after picture of you, Barb, before we started. Get the sound. And this is where see if it can come up another. I found a YouTube on how to plant carrots. It's going to make it easier. If you want it, I'll send it to you. But you know how tiny the carrot seeds are, and they all get too close together. And this will help that. You can feel now back there. There's a little bit more tension, so just keep massaging your shoulder. Sometimes you get started on this. special cream. Won't say anything else about that. Product placement. Okay, and then a little cream on your hands. And see, when you're stressed, you'll find yourself often holding your fists tight like this, because that's part of the fight or flight response. You're getting ready to, you know, either run really hard or punch someone out. So when you do that, the muscles between your bones here get really tight, so you can, like, and there also is a theory that as foot reflexology and ear reflexology and hand reflexology, that you can affect every part of your body and by massaging your hands. And that, and it's pretty important to go right up, because if you make a fist, you'll feel this muscle here tighten really hard. And so if you're tight all day long clenching your fists, that muscle gets very tender and full of lactic acid, and it's great to relax it with a little massage. And all down. And it doesn't really matter. I mean, it does if you're taking your RMT exams, but just whatever feels good in your arm. And keep going. Spread your fingers wide too, because that helps. That helps relieve those muscles in your fingers, in between your fingers. There's also a very strong relaxation point right here between your thumb and your first finger. And I think they call it the headache point. If you have a headache and you press that for a little while, you feel things start to relax. And just check it out, like just squeeze that spot and see if you can feel your body relax. And it's important to keep checking in on your body and to check in that you're very present with your body. Like, so you kind of feel your butt on the chair, like be aware of where you're sitting, be aware of your breath. And feel your breath. Keep massaging though, don't neglect the massage, but just feel your breathing. Watch that you're not holding your breath. Because that's another thing we do when we're scared, is we hold our breath in and oh, I hope I don't make myself cough now. Barb will have to back up. doesn't that feel good? I'm just going to sit here for a while and do that. Barb wanted a chair here for me, so it didn't look like I was all alone, so I told her. And the women of the regular crew in the circle will understand. You're just sitting there. If you're looking at this for the first time, you won't know what I'm talking about. And that's okay. Uh-oh. Barb brought me a Ricola, so in case I started my allergy cough here. Sorry about that. So it's good to shake your hands too. And you can even come up and, you know. Now in the class, we usually do the foot massage. I'm not going to do it today because I had hip surgery about 3.5 months ago and I can't get my foot up yet. It's coming. The other one I get. But that's another thing you can do if you can reach your feet easily, is to massage your feet. everybody does the stretches the way they want to. I should be looking more at Barb so it makes it seem like I'm looking at you. Is that better, Barb? Stretch your arms out behind you. Shake a bit and then. The more sounds you can make, the better. I really believe making noise. Sometimes we've had people come down and tell us to keep it quiet. Shake. Jimmy around and sit back down. And we usually finish the circle with a sort of a guided imagery. Maybe I'll show you. Remember, we'll do the Hawaiian healing technique to start retreats. I learned from a shaman in Hawaii and it helps. So it's good if you have a headache or like you check out your body and see where is the spot that doesn't feel comfortable. And for me this morning, it's this shoulder is a little tense and sore. I've been too much weeding in the garden, I think. But what you say is you stay out loud and clear what the problem is. I have a pain in my right shoulder. And that can change. And I want that pain to go away. I want it to change and disappear. And then place your hands over your thymus here, which is you'll feel it's just very relaxing to do that. It's almost like a prayer position. And you're asking for this pain to leave. Hold it for maybe 10, 15 seconds. And then pinch that point, the relaxation point in your hand between your thumb and your finger. Again, another 10, 15 seconds. And to the other side. The last 2 points are at the back of your neck. You know where just where your neck hits your shoulders. You saw there's a little lump there in a very tender spot. And so you just hold that very tightly. And I can feel the difference already in my shoulder, like as I can hold my arm up higher than I could before. So the theory behind this is that you have to acknowledge what's wrong, believe that it can change, ask for it to change, and then completely relax. And these 4 points that you touch here, your fingers, in the back of your neck, those are all relaxation points. And so once your body relaxes and you've asked for healing, it generally happens, and it's quite interesting and easy to do. And if it works, great. If it doesn't, it hasn't hurt you. So it doesn't have to be anything magical. So we would do something like that, and then we do a guided imagery for, or go into meditation. Everybody has their own way of stilling their mind, because boy, these days you can just worry about everything, you know, and that's the whole point of meditation, is just to shut that mind up. And if it takes is just feeling your breath, that's always a good one. I like that technique. Some people have a mantra that they imagine that you have an eye right here in the middle of your forehead, and you look out through that eye as far in the distance as you can. And focus in there and look out. And keep seeing what you can see. You may see colors, but you notice that your mind isn't as busy when you're doing that. So it'll take a little bit of time just to be in that relaxed state. Think good thoughts about people. Give a loving kindness hug to everyone who is frightened and afraid. And another good mantra is, let's relax, everything's going to be okay. And just let that happen. This is where if we had beautiful music, we'd just let it play until we ran out. I don't want to move, Barb. How are you doing? So, I hope you enjoyed the video. All of you that are watching for the first time, hope you don't think we're as crazy as we are, but it sure feels good, and I miss you guys coming here. Oh, I miss it terribly. But everything's going to be okay. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for doing this, Barb. What a good idea.